That's it, honey. Hold it up so we can see it.
So can you tell the readers of life how it feels? I mean, to be a girl among all those men.
I don't mind it.
Isn't it intimidating? I mean, when I was a girl, I wasn't allowed to be competitive. I played with dolls.
Chess isn't always competitive.
No, but you play to win.
Yes, but chess can also be...
What?
Beautiful.
You're an orphan, Beth.
Yes, I know that.
No, yes, of course you do. I was just wondering how you learned to play chess.
Mr. Scheibel taught me. He was the janitor at Methuen.
A janitor taught you how to play? Really?
When I was 8.
I imagine. It must have been such a distraction from life in such a depressing place. I mean, you must have been very lonely.
I'm fine being alone.
Do you imagine that you saw the king as a father and the queen as a mother? I mean, one to attack, one to protect.
They're just pieces. And anyway, it was the board I noticed first.
The board?
Yes. It's an entire world of just 64 squares. I feel safe in it. I can control it. I can dominate it. And it's predictable. So if I get hurt, I only have myself to blame.
How interesting. Tell me, Elizabeth, have you ever heard of something called apophenia?
No, what's that?
It's the finding of pattern or meaning where other people don't. Sometimes people with this condition get feelings of revelation or ecstasies. Sometimes people find patterns or meaning where there aren't any.
What does that have to do with me?
Well, creativity and psychosis often go hand in hand. Or for that matter, genius and madness.
You think I'm crazy?
No, of course not.
I think that's enough.
I was just asking.
Beth has homework to finish. She is, after all, still a young woman in school. Just like all the other kids her age.
Yes, of course. It was an honor to meet you.
Thanks.
You know, you might try bridge. I hear a lot of chess players enjoy it.
I'll show you out.